I'll show you the game. That's my favorite game in the universe. I've been playing this since I was a little kid. I grew up in Tennessee, Clarksville, Tennessee, a little town in the northern part of the state. I was a preacher's kid. And when I grew up, when I was growing up, this old man, when I was about 9, moved into the neighborhood across the street and changed my life forever. He was in his 80s. He'd been a professional gambler his whole life. He claimed to have played with Wyatt Earp, and he drank whiskey right straight out of the bottle and chain smoked these little black cigars and cussed like a sailor. So naturally, as a preacher's kid, I gravitated toward his society. This is one of the things he taught me that has stood me in good stead over the years, called the shell game. It uses three little half-water shells and a little pea. Now, these aren't real half walnut shells. When I started out, they were. I ate the walnut. I carved the shells out. I practiced with them till my hands were bloody. I got really good at it, but these are fake. These are solid sterling silver, folks. I have been very lucky at this game over the years. I was able to get my nuts cast in silver. They ring better that way, but that's not the point. The point is the game hasn't changed. The game is still the same. You want to keep up with that little pea. If you know where the pea is, you bet against me. This lady right here, you look like you have a pair of eyes on you. What's your name?
Alice.
Alice? We'll play a little game.
All right.
Oh, good, good. Where's Pete?
In the middle
one. Alice, you have eyes like a red-tailed hawk. I'm going to have to move the shells around to beat you. You still want to play, though, right? Because, Alice, I get a lot of complaints, especially from the ladies. They say you started too fast or I wasn't ready. I don't want to hear any crap like that. You know where the pee is, Alice. You know where it is not. Are you ready to go? Let's go. Oh, the speed. The blinding, blinding speed. I am lost myself. Oh, nobody can beat this game. They always let you win the first time. Where is it, Alice? This one here. Yeah, that's a loser. No, remember the first time she said it was in the middle. That was a winner. This is the second time. Everybody always loses the second time. I'll do it a third time. They don't even do that on the street, Alice. I would go here if I was you. This one? Alice, you should listen to me. I actually know where it is. But that's okay, you learned something. You learned what? Pop knows where the pee is, and you can trust Pop. Let's play again. See what else we might learn. You ready? You know where the pee is, Alice. You know where it's not. You ready to go? Oh, the speed. The blinding speed. I'm lost myself. Whoop. Ooh. Oh. Where is it? Alice, I would go here.
I would go there.
Okay, now you learned something new. Not that you can't trust me, but you have to know when. This strategy is going to work with most men. Now, folks, I'll show you why people lose at this game. The reason is the pee does not stay under the shell it starts from. If you watch between the shells, you'll see that pee actually move from one shell to another, like it's got little legs, like a clam. That's at half speed. At full speed, you can't see anything. Kelsey, look, if I go like, oh, that's half speed, see? Full speed, it's like, when full speed, it looks so obvious. Half speed, I'll do it once at half speed, once at full speed. That way you have something to compare. Ready?
Yeah.
Well, one was half speed. One was full speed. Folks, I'll tell you a little bit about the history of this game. We don't know who invented it. Could have been a man, could have been a woman. We really don't know. The origins have been lost in the mires of time. Good night, Alice. You guys have a good one. So I can say just about anything that I want. This game was invented by a man, and his name was Frog. He was a Neanderthal fella, played with half a coconut shell and a little white smooth river pebble he found on the beach. That was his favorite toy. By accident one day, as he was fooling around the way those Neanderthals were wont to do, he accidentally covered the pea with the shell. And when he turned back around, it was as if the pea just disappeared into thin air. He looked all over it, he couldn't find it. By accident, he picked up the shell, and there it was. Well, it wouldn't be a big deal for me either. But to a Neanderthal, this was like a 2001 moment. It's kept him occupied all afternoon. It was a simpler time. He took it back to the campfire, showed it to the other Neanderthals. It became the most popular game of the Neanderthal period, called the one shell game. Now, as man's cranial capacity grew, the game lost some of its cachet. Till some genius, Cro-Magnon man, came up with the idea of adding two more shells, creating what we would call a three-shell game, although they didn't play it the way we do today. They would just move these two around to confuse people. This was before logic had been invented. By the Greeks. Well, before logic was invented, they always wanted to bet on one of those two because they were the ones who were moving. I know, but before logic was invented, that wouldn't mean anything to a modern crowd.
Oh my God.
All right, look. All right. I can see you got the bit in your teeth. I'll let you do it. Put the shell on top of the pea.
Really?
Yeah.
Do it.
Harder than it looks. Put the shell on top of that. Perfect. All right, now, hold your finger out like that. Okay, that's your thumb. There you go. No, finger, you're right, the first time. That was good. You get to pick one of these. Most people fall for that. He's really sharp. You get to pick one of these, turn it face down, either one. With that hand. Yeah. And turn it face down, put your finger on top of it. On yours. This way you look at the situation, you know where the pea is, you have control of it. You have control of two of the shells. You have 2-1 odds. On the street, this is what they call a lead pipe cinch. On the street, they rip their pockets, taking every dime they've got. They throw it on the table, they pile it high. They say stupid, stupid things like, "Pop, I've got you now." Or you would never do that, would you?
I would not.
No, because you're an intelligent man. And you know the instant a dime hits this table, what's going to happen?
Oh.
Check. It's like a little miracle, I think.
Whoa!
This is Shell Game. I'm Pop Haydn. You guys have a nice evening. Woo!
Thank you, guys.